You know, I need to get one of those custom-made soap opera openings for my channel now, because that's what OU football has become. This is better than Netflix, HBO, whatever you want to throw out there as an example. So, the drama continues in ways you didn't expect. So, Roy Manning, currently under contract at Oklahoma, currently recruiting for Oklahoma with Bob Stoops in person, who was visiting guys like Robert Spears Jennings in home, visiting, saying, hey, how's it going? Blah, blah, blah. We're just, trying to put out some flames, this and that. Meanwhile, in California, a big five-star defensive back, Damani Jackson, who is down to Alabama and USC, and, Lincoln Riley is already going after him hard, and why shouldn't he, try to get all the big, high-quality, big-time blue-chip talent you can. And then he was quoted from 24/7 talking about how he's going to make his decision on the early signing period and all that stuff. He's like, yeah, he wants to send in Alex Grinch. And then I've been texting back and forth with Roy Manning, who was the former cornerbacks coach at OU. That's news to everyone, including Bob Stoops, including everyone at OU. So here we are, where we have a mole, literally a mole, who stayed behind or is waiting for his right moment to make the jump. Ain't that something? Well, this might be a misunderstanding. It's like, no, the recruit quoted him, said him by name. I don't think that's an accident. I'm not gullible when it comes to this anymore. Like, those days are done. I don't know what the punishment could potentially be, but I'm vengeful right now. I don't know if Riley can be tied to this. I hope so. I'm vengeful right now. It would be so beautiful if year one, their first game next year, they're already on probation on some level. Now, look, at the end of the day, do I expect much to come from this outside of Roy Manning straight up getting fired? Not that it's going to matter anyway. No. Because whoever they hire at OU, Roy Manning is not sticking around. So let's just put it that way. So yeah, that was fun last night, going over that and seeing players react. And then OU compliance had a babyface turn last night because they went on Twitter and made themselves pretty they made it pretty well known with a few little emojis that they're on the case. It's ironic. It's like the Austin Bret Hart, double switch babyface heel turn, at least for one incident. Still kind of hate OU compliance overall, but yeah, that happened last night. So who knows what will come from this. I'm sure Bob's not happy. Misunderstanding or not, that's not good, and it's not good for Lincoln Riley either, but screw him anyway. I hope he gets gonorrhea in his eyes. That's what I hope right now. So I know everyone's still waiting on head coaching news. Kerry Murdoch on the Sports Animal this morning, from what I understand, has said expect something official tomorrow, but you'll probably hear about it today, Wednesday. So I don't know if that means Brent Venables. I would like to believe it's Brent Venables. But it'll be interesting to see if it's just him or they actually have more coaching announcements, and because there's so much smoke for a lot of different things right now. Talking about Venables, I know the Georgia D coordinator is out there as coming over as D coordinator. I don't see that happening, unfortunately. It'd be interesting to see if it does. If Jamar Cain, as long as Jamar Cain's not a mole too, I would love for Jamar Cain to potentially be D coordinator because he's a fantastic recruiter. So I don't know. We're still kind of in wait and see mode, but yeah, I'm recording this early in the morning because that's just what I've been doing lately, because getting some videos out of the way early in the day. That way I have time to do one later in the afternoon if need be. So we should hopefully hear something today, unofficial, if you get my drift. Like, we're grown-ups with blue check marks, like the Bruce Feldmans and the Pete Thamels of the world are saying these things. Or I'll take Kerry Murdoch. I'll even take a Kerry Murdoch. But right now, we're just still kind of waiting. see what happens, and I'm sure people will line up the video with comments saying, have you heard the news? Trust me, this has been my, this is all I've been paying attention to for the past 3 or 4 days. I'm aware. I got my phone on standby. I'm ready to go. So with that being said, we have a traitor in our midst. Another one. And God, we need to get a new head coach in here soon. Need to feel, get a sense of normalcy again. Anyway, that's all I got for now. Update as the Sooner world turns. So, Boomer Sooner, I'll catch y'all later.